Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about program libraries. So for this video, you will be learning on what are program libraries, benefits of program libraries, quick demo of program libraries using Python, what is static program library and dynamic link library, which is DLL, and finally the pros and cons of using DLL. So first of all, what is program libraries? Program library is a pre-written code that can be linked to a software under development without any amendments. So you can think of it this way. A program library just like a big book that has a lot of ideas and instructions that a computer can use to execute different tasks. And next, when program libraries are used. So program libraries will store pre-written functions and routines so that these functions or routines can be called in the new program. So as I say, this big book has a lot of ideas and execution, and the new program can just call the ideas or execution to perform different tasks. And next, the program libraries also can be referenced or imported. So later on, I will just show you a basic import of libraries using Python. So what are the benefits of program libraries? So first of all, it removes the need to rewrite many routines every single time. So it actually saves time and cost. So as I said, in the big book, there are a lot of instructions and ideas that were written by other people. So we can just take the ideas or instruction from this book and implement into our new program. And next, it also leads to modular programming, which means several programmers can be working on the same piece of software at the same time. It also allows shorter testing time since the routines are pre-tested and used by others. So it means that a lot of bugs and issues that you might be facing when you're actually developing your program have been faced by the previous user. So by the time the program libraries reach your hand, it's already well maintained. And next, it also allows users to perform complex tasks or algorithms without the need of understanding. So just think of it this way. You can ask the computer to perform certain math calculation without knowing the formula or how the calculation is being done. And now let's look at the demo of program libraries. Let's start with a basic question, which is, what is the circumference of a circle with radius 3 cm? And let's look at how can we take advantage of program libraries to do this calculation. So first of all, I have my Python notebook open, and let's just copy the question. So the question was, what's the circumference of a circle with radius 3 cm? So let's do the radius first. So radius is equal to 3. And then for the output, we can just name the variables as circumference. It's a bit long, but I think it should be okay. So just copy this and put it here. And what is the formula for circumference? It's 2 pi r. So it's going to be 2 times. And what is the value for pi? So let me just do a Google search. So I have my Google tab open, and let's just search for what is the value of pi. So this is the value of pi based on Google. So let's just copy this variable here. So let me just copy this whole thing here. Command C here, and let's just go back to the notebook. So when I come back to the notebook here, I'm just gonna paste the value for pi here. So just do a Command V here, and then just gonna multiply by the radius. And then maybe I can just do an output, just do a simple print. So print the circumference for a circle with radius. And then I'm just gonna put radius here. Is circumference. Let me check whether I'm spelling it correctly. Okay, so just like that. And let me just run the program first. And after 3 seconds or so for the initialization of the Python notebook, so this is the output here. The circumference for a circle with radius 3 is 18.849, and we have a lot of numbers at the end here. So this is the answer here. So this is how we can calculate the circumference of a circle without using any program libraries. We'll just do a Google search on the value of pi, and then we just plug in the formula, and then we just calculate the circumference. And now let's do another way, which is a bit faster using program libraries. So I'm just going to clear all the output and go to the next line here. So I'm just gonna clear the output first, edit, clear all outputs, and then just go to the next line here. So just click on enter here. And now this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to import the math library. So let's look at this. Import math. So you can think of this math library just like a big book that I mentioned. It has a lot of functions, a lot of formulas, have a lot of variables inside this big book. And we can just use any ideas or instruction from this book for our new program. So import math. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to write down the same circumference again. So I'm going to do like maybe circumference, maybe just make it 2. And then I'm just going to write is equal to 2 times math dot pi times radius. So let's look at this. Instead of going to Google and search for the value of pi, I am actually using the value of pi from this math library here. And then I'm just going to define circumference 2 is equal to this formula here. And then I will be doing the same thing, which is printing the output. So let me just copy from the top statement here. So enter here and just copy this. Command C, Command V. And then I'm just going to change this to circumference 2. And yeah, that's it. And now I'm just gonna run this program again. So if you look at this right now, the first line here is from our first statement here, which is using this 3.14 with a lot of decimal places. And the second line is from this math.py library, whereby this is the new value here. So definitely if you look at this, the first line is gonna be more accurate since it has more decimal places, which is like maybe just one decimal place extra here, which is just two here. And it doesn't really matter because most of the time our answer just need to be like maybe 2 to 3 decimal places is more than enough. And here you go, this is the basic walkthrough of program libraries using Python. You can see how powerful program libraries are just by looking at this basic demo. And now let's look at dynamic link libraries file. So in general, all operating systems have two types of program libraries. So the first type will be static. It means that software being developed is linked to executable code in the library at the time of compilation. It means library routines would be embedded directly into new program code. So for static library, just remember that the keyword is time of compilation. It means that when you compile the software code, you have to put all the executable code that you use in your program during the time of compilation. And next would be dynamic. It means that software being developed is not linked to the library routine until actual runtime. So it's also known as dynamic link library file, which is DLL here. Basically, it means library routines are not loaded into main memory until required, thus saving memory and allowing software to run faster. For example, a software that allows access to the printer, the program will only contain a link to the printer library routine and access or load the printer routine from DLL when required. So it means that for this software, it actually does not have to embed all the printer code into the software. It only needs to contain the shortcut link to the library DLL. And when it's actually being used, it will just call the DLL through the shortcut. And next, routine will be available to several applications at the same time. And it's also used as modules in more complex programs. So just remember this way, for static, you will always need the code, means that you need to embed the whole code during the time of compilation. It means that when you build the code, you need your executable code inside your program. And for dynamic, it only loads a library routine during the actual runtime. It means that when you're running this program and you need to perform this specific function, only you will load the actual library routine. And finally, let's look at the pros and cons of using DLL file. So the first pro is executable code of the main program is much smaller since DLL files are only loaded into memory at runtime, saving memory. So as I say, you will only need the DLL file at the actual runtime. And next, DLL files can be made available to a number of applications at the same time and saving memory. So it means that let's say in your computer, you have like 10 software and they all need this printing function. You will only need one single copy of DLL instead of 10 copies of DLL for every single program. And also, make changes to DLL files independently of the main program, so recompilation of the main program is not required. So this is the biggest upside of using dynamic library compared to static library. So for static library, you have to recompile the code every time you make any changes, but for dynamic library, you don't have to do that. You just have to update the DLL file. And definitely DLL also comes with some cons. So the first con will be executable code is not self-contained. It means that all DLL files need to be available at runtime. Otherwise, error messages such as missing.dll will be generated, causing software crash. I'm pretty sure if you have been using computer a lot, definitely you have encountered this error before whereby it says that missing.dll, let's say you just accidentally deleted the DLL from your computer system, it will always show this missing.dll file, which is a bit hard to troubleshoot. So this is the downside of DLL since the code is not embedded during the time of compilation. And next will be, if any of the DLL files have been changed, it could lead to main program giving unexpected results or even crashing. So remember the 10 software examples, let's say this 10 software here, maybe you do some update to the DLL file. What happens is that maybe 5 of them can still work normally, but the other 5 will just keep crashing because maybe there was some compatibility issue or some other random issues. And finally, malicious changes to DLL files could pose security risk to the program. And before we end, let's look at some questions from the past year regarding this topic. So the first question would be, Jennifer uses a program library to help her write her computer program. And then describe how a program library can be used while writing a computer program. So this is a 2-mark question. And the next question is, state 2 benefits to a programmer of using dynamic link libraries DLL files. So all the answers are actually inside this video. Definitely just try to find the answer and comment below for your answer. Thank you, and I'll see you again then. Bye bye.